Here's our roundup of the best video editors for iOS right now in 2020. We're gonna take a look at the leading options after our in-depth testing and finish with the reveal of my top pick for best video editing app on iPhone and iPad. Hey, it's Justin Brown here from Primal Video, where we help you amplify your business and brand with video. If you're new here, make sure you click that subscribe button and all the links to everything we mentioned in this video, you can find linked in the description box below. So let's jump into it. Okay, so after testing all the latest options, we're gonna take a look at the best video editors available right now on iPad and iPhone. And as we go through, make sure to let me know down in the comments, what's your favorite video editing app for iOS? And most importantly, why? Now, there is lots of options out there when it comes to video editing apps. You've got things like Adobe Premiere Rush, a Light Motion, Video Leap, Filmora Go, iMovie, InShot, KineMaster, LumaFusion, PowerDirector, Quick, Viva Video, VLLO or VLO or VLO, and WeVideo. So there's definitely a lot of options out there, but what I've done is I've created a shortlist of my top four. Now, just before we get to the shortlist, I do want to mention a couple of apps here really quickly that just couldn't fit into the top four. Hey, there's only four of them. But they are still really good apps and they'll still let you create professional videos really, really fast. And they are a Light Motion, Video Leap, KineMaster, and PowerDirector. So a Light Motion doesn't have the most intuitive interface, but it's still a really powerful app. It's also a motion graphics and animation app, not just video editing. Video Leap has an awesome, really intuitive interface with some pro-level features in there as well. KineMaster is one that we've been recommending on our channel for a long time, and it's even taken out the title of best video editing app on iOS previously. This time around though, like I said, it's got some tough competition. And PowerDirector is a new one to iOS. It's been a great app on Android for a long time. They finally have an iOS version, but I still don't think it stacks up, especially to limit this down to a top four list. So as for our shortlist then, that includes Adobe Premiere Rush, InShot, LumaFusion, and VLLO. Now, I did do a quick Google search and couldn't find how you actually pronounce it, so I'm just gonna call it VLO. So without teasing these any longer, app number one on the shortlist is Adobe Premiere Rush. Now, I'm a massive fan of Adobe Premiere Rush. I think it's so easy to use. I think the interface is really intuitive. I think if you're an absolute beginner, you're going to be able to start editing fast in here without too much overwhelm or too much confusion. But if you are someone who is more on the advanced side of things, you're gonna have a heap of professional level features in here that are going to allow you to create the videos that you want in this app as well. So it's a good mix of beginner through to advanced features. But probably the biggest standout feature with Adobe Premiere Rush is the fact that it is cross-device, cross-platform compatible, meaning that you can use this on pretty much anything. On your iOS devices, your iPhone, your iPad, on your Mac, on your PC, you can start a project on one and open it up on the other. And then open it up on another if you'd like. So it's the only app out there that works cross-device and cross-platform, but also it's kind of like the little baby brother of the professional video editing software, Adobe Premiere Pro. And what you can do is start your projects in Adobe Premiere Rush and you can open them up inside of Adobe Premiere. So if you do want to upgrade your projects or open them up inside of the professional grade software, then you have that ability as well. There's some great features in there that make it really quick for you to edit your videos down. Things like audio ducking and audio auto levels. So it's automatically going to adjust everything for you based on the clips or the music that you're using in your videos. It also makes reformatting your video projects really, really easy. So if you're starting with a widescreen video for YouTube and you want to create an Instagram story version, a portrait video, with the click of a button, you can easily convert and switch between the two. The biggest downsides I found with Rush is that it can be a little bit buggy from time to time, but in saying that, it really hasn't been for a long time. So I'm hoping that they've fixed all of that in the most recent updates. But also it's worth knowing that you actually can't reverse a clip or play a clip backwards. I don't know why, it seems to be something that even the most basic video editing software has, except for Rush. It's not a deal breaker, but it's worth knowing that if you need to reverse your clips or play them backwards, can't do it in Rush yet. As for pricing, there is a free version, but it only lets you export or save out three projects. So you're really gonna be looking at one of the paid options. And it is a subscription model. It's $9.99 per month for access to Adobe Premiere Rush. Or you can also bundle it with some of the other Adobe programs. So if you've already got a license for Adobe Premiere Pro, then you've already got a license for Adobe Rush as well. But a package deal of Adobe Premiere Rush and Adobe Premiere Pro started around $20.99 per month. month. So I really think Adobe Premiere Rush is a great option for anyone who is that absolute beginner right through to advanced, given the amount of features and control, but also how easy it is to use. And obviously, if you're someone who is a beginner looking to advance your editing, this could be a great leg up for you into Adobe Premiere Pro when you're ready. Now, the next one on the list is InShot. And I want to come out and say this straight away, that this is probably the most basic app in our shortlist. And yes, some of the other ones that didn't make the shortlist have more features and more control over InShot. But I think this app is definitely worth looking at if you want to be able to edit your videos down fast without a heap of extra features. The features that they give you in there are fantastic, but they're not going to overwhelm you. So this is going to be perfect for an absolute beginner or someone who just wants to make minor edits and make their stuff look good and quickly get it out on social media. So like I said, this app is really, really easy to use. It's really fast to edit in. The interface, super intuitive. But there's a couple of things in this app that they've done which are really cool that make it easy for you to edit your videos fast. The first is that you can set up your effects or your color correction or your formatting and how you want a clip to look. And you can tick a box and you can apply it to all the clips in your timeline or in your edit. This is something that you normally only see in the really high end, the really professional app. So this is awesome that they have it in a more basic app like this. Just like Adobe Premiere Rush, they make it really easy to quickly change the format of your video. So if you are someone who is going to be repurposing your content, I really like the way that they handle it in InShot and how fast and easy they make it. Even for doing things like putting a widescreen video and converting it through to portrait, it's literally just clicking at the different options or adjusting the background color to be able to add subtitles or to add a blur in the background. This is all stuff that you can do in a lot of the other apps, but it is so easy and so fast in InShot. So as for the downsides then, as I said, this app is not a pro level app. It's not gonna have all the advanced control and advanced features that you're gonna have in the more professional apps. You also have no control over the frame rate of your video, and there's also only one video layer or one video track that you can use to create your video. So if you're looking for something more advanced where you're gonna be stacking clips on top of each other, like adding B-roll or overlay footage, you can't do that in InShot. Now, in regards to pricing, there is a free version of InShot. It does have a watermark, but you can watch an ad to remove it. So if you watch the ad, you don't actually have to pay to remove the watermark, which means that you can use InShot totally for free and create unbranded videos, which is awesome. The other options you've got though is you can pay $1.99 to remove ads totally from the app, or you can remove the ads and unlock more features, more stickers, more effects, and those sorts of things with their pro plan, which is either $4.39 per month, or you can pay a one-time fee and purchase the app outright for around the $43 price point. So rounding that out, InShot I think is an amazing app for editing your videos really quickly, for repurposing them, for adding captions and those sorts of things if you need to. But I would say it's definitely aimed at more of the beginner to intermediate. If you're an advanced user, you could probably use something like InShot just to do a really quick edit to save you opening up one of these other apps and getting everything set up. Editing down something fast is really where I see InShot fitting into this list. Or it'd be perfect for someone who doesn't want to get bogged down in all of the advanced features and advanced controls. The next one on the list is LumaFusion. Now, this is hands down the most powerful, most advanced video editing app on iOS right now. This thing is absolutely amazing. It is really mimicking what you would get on something like Adobe Premiere Pro or Final Cut, but on your iOS device. So this app pretty much has all the bells and whistles, everything you need from creating a short, quick little clip right through to an actual documentary or a film. There are people out there that are using their iPads and iOS devices to edit down major videos using LumaFusion. Now the interface itself definitely isn't the easiest to use, especially when comparing to some of these other apps that we've mentioned here, but it really is because of all the advanced features and controls and settings and stuff that you have in there. So I really don't see that as a downside. And if you are someone who has edited before on a different program or a different app, it's not gonna take you too long to get up to speed in here, but you will be blown away with the amount of features and control that you have. One of the things that I really love about LumaFusion is the amount of performance and power that you have in there. You can literally drop in multiple 4K clips, drop them straight in the timeline, you're able to scrub through them, play them back, add effects and everything all without missing a beat. And even on an older iOS device, I've had great success using LumaFusion on an older iPhone 7 with multiple 4K clips. And yeah, hasn't missed a beat. I also really love some of the simple stuff that they've added in from what you would normally see in a desktop video editing application. Things like the ability to easily and quickly lower the volume on a track by track level, or to easily pick up and move clips around, but keeping everything in sync. It's almost like it's a hybrid of Premiere and Final Cut with the Final Cut's magic timeline in there. And it's also really cool that you can easily switch and change up the layout or the interface. So depending on what you're actually doing or what device you're using, if you're on a smaller screen or a bigger screen, you can customize up the layout so that it's going to work best for you with what it is that you're doing. So in regards to pricing then, there is no free version. This is a one-time purchase, but really it is ridiculously cheap at $29.99, considering that this is the most powerful video editing app out there on iOS. So I would recommend LumaFusion to anyone who is an intermediate through to advanced level. If you're a beginner, you could still look at this as well. I would say that the learning curve for you is definitely going to be greater than some of the other apps. But if you do want to grow and learn and master video editing, then this could be the perfect app for a beginner as well. But for an intermediate to advanced level person, this is going to do everything that you need with all of those advanced features and controls. And yeah, it's ridiculously cheap. And the last one then, app number four, is Velo. Now this is one that's relatively new to me. I've spent a lot of time with it recently, but this is something that we have never recommended before. And I've got to say, when I first opened the app and saw the welcome screen that showed up, I was kind of like, oh, it's just one of those template, theme-based, really basic editors. But it's actually the complete opposite. It is awesome. It doesn't have all of the pro features and things that LumaFusion does. It probably doesn't even have as intuitive interface as Adobe Premiere Rush, but it is still really easy to use and it does have some amazing features in there. One of the standout features for me in there is the adjustment layers and the effect layers, where you can apply all of your effects or any adjustments that you want to have, and they are applied to all the clips that are below, or in this case, above, the actual adjustment layer. So working with adjustment layers and being able to bulk apply or batch apply things to your entire clips, or even just to multiple clips in one sitting, is just insane. This is something that only the more professional desktop video editing apps have, not normally seen on an app like this. So it's a great addition. There's also some really cool features in there, like being able to ripple edit left, ripple edit right. So you're able to cut your timeline and remove a chunk in one step instead of going through and adding a cut and selecting and deleting. So there's some ways that you can edit your videos down fast. And LumaFusion has this as well, which is why I'm really blown away that you have it in this app too. I also really like the way that they display the audio waveform, or the visual representation of the audio in your videos on top of the clips themselves. This is something that most video editing apps don't include at all, let alone to present it as well as it is in this app. It makes it so much easier to edit your footage down if you've got audio in your videos, because you can visually see where those audio markers are. And this is another app that makes it really easy to change between the different video formats. So if you are interested in repurposing your content, you can easily do it in here. And you also have the ability in here to stack or to layer your video clips. So if you do want to do some more advanced edits and drop in things like B-roll or overlay footage, you can do that in here too. Now, just while we're on the multiple video layers, while you can do it in there and while it works pretty well, I don't think it's as intuitive, or it's more cumbersome than something like Adobe Premiere Rush or something like LumaFusion when it comes to how you're just stacking the videos on its own separate layer. Stacking a video in here is almost nesting the video inside of the other one. So this isn't too bad if you're only going to add one additional layer, but if you want to add two or three, that's when it becomes hard to work with, and that's when it really becomes hard to switch and select between which clip you want to adjust. So in regards to pricing, there is a free version of this app which does not have a watermark included, meaning that you can just use the basic features, export your video, and it's not going to have any branding or watermark on it. But in order to totally unlock the app and access all of the pro level features, including things like the multiple video tracks, then you will need to purchase the app for a one-time fee. And this one is ridiculously cheap at $14.99 one-time fee. So I'd recommend Velo to anyone who is on the absolute beginner level right through to an advanced user. I think you're gonna have tools and features in there that are gonna work across the board. If you just wanna do simple stuff, you've got it. It's gonna be really intuitive for you to do that. But if you wanna have access to a lot of those extra features and things, you've got those in there too. And obviously for someone on the more advanced side of things, having access to those adjustment layers and the level of control that you have over the way you actually edit in the timeline, this is gonna be a great pick for you too. But it definitely doesn't have all of the advanced features and control as something like LumaFusion. So those are our top four video editing apps on iOS right now. Now it's gonna be tough, but if I had to pick a winner, I would say it's gonna go to LumaFusion, hands down, because of the amount of features and control that you have. There is nothing that really comes close to the level of professional tools and professional features that you have in there. It really is like desktop video editing application or video editing software on your iOS device. I'm someone who's been editing professionally for a very long time, and it is just insane what you are getting for $29.99 as a one-time fee. Plus, it's really amazing how well it works even with multiple layers of 4K video. It's just, yeah, well done. Well played. Now I do want to add in here a really quick runner up, and that is to Adobe Premiere Rush. I love that it is cross-platform, cross-device, that I can start it on one device, open it on another, but also that you're able to edit really fast without getting bogged down in a heap of settings and stuff, but it still has a lot of pro tools and everything in there. So that's my close runner up, and I'm also totally blown away with VLO or VLLO. I'm sure this video next year is going to look a little different because what they're doing, and obviously at their price point too, yeah, it's gonna be an interesting year and it's gonna be interesting to see what they do. So now that you have your video editing app sorted, if you're looking for the most efficient and the fastest way to edit your videos down with minimal wasted time or rework, check out the video linked on screen now for our process on the most efficient way for editing videos. And I'll see you in the next one.